Hi, I'm Carol Den Hartog with Amazing Business Results. And today we are going to talk about workflow roles inside of Zoho Recruit. So a workflow is a type of way to automate inside of the system. There is two different ways. So we have blueprints, which would be clicking on a button to create an automation. And then we have workflow rules. So workflow rules happen in the background, and it's based on some sort of a trigger. So think about it as an if-then rule. So if there is a value in this field, then this email goes out. So that's kind of the concept behind it. So if we go to our settings in the upper right-hand corner, we are then going to go to workflow rules under automation, and this will show us all of our workflow rules that we currently have. So we will click create rule. And just like anything inside of Zoho, we're going to choose what module we want this to run on. So let's say we want applications, and we will give it a name. And side note, when you are giving your workflow rules a name, make sure that you're very, very specific. Because if you just use one word and you don't really describe what it's for, when you come back to clean up your workflow rules in a year, you're not going to remember why you created it or what it's for. So it's really important that you give it an actual good name. So when we start, this is identical to workflow rules in the CRM. So if you know how to create a workflow rule inside the CRM, then you know how to create a workflow rule inside of Zoho Recruit. So the first thing we're going to have is our when. So when do you want to execute this rule? So you can do it on a record action or on a date and time. So record action would be the most common. So we can do create, edit, status change, create or change status, or on a candidate applying for a job. So I'm going to choose on a candidate applying for a job. And then we can have applications matching certain conditions or all applications. So typically you're not going to do all applications. It'll be very slim that you're always going to send something out all the time. So we would choose a criteria. A criteria is also a great way to test out your workflow. So you don't want to start sending things out with a workflow until you test them first. So what you can do is, let's say first name is test. So that way, unless the candidate's first name is test, this workflow is not going to trigger. So you would leave it on this test condition. You would test it out. So you would create a record where the first name is test. You would let that email go out. You would receive it into your inbox, make sure everything looks good. And then you would come back and you would remove this condition so that it'll go live, essentially. So for the purpose of this, though, we're going to do all applications. So anytime any candidate applies for a job, what we are going to do is notify via email. So we would choose a email template that we already have in the system. So we would just click and then we would associate it. And then you would save your workflow here. And there are lots of different actions that you can choose. So you can create a task, you can update a field, you can create a tag. And then you have instant actions and you have scheduled actions. So an instant action means as soon as this record is created, this email is going to go out. Let's say I wanted a delay. Maybe I want this email to go out after one day. Then I'm going to choose a scheduled action because then I can do execute after one day. So that's kind of the difference there. And if you are trying to create workflow rules on your system, if you need help creating them, if you don't want to create them and you need someone to do it for you, or if you need some training on the system, then you can always reach out to us at Amazing Business Results and we'd be happy to help.